Hello everyone! Today I'm going to show you how I've established a first short-term habitat on the surface of the Moon. It all starts with launching a satellite with orbital scanners. It will be placed in polar orbit of the Moon and it will make an altimetry and biomap of lunar surface. It will help to determine the best place to land my habitat. The satellite itself is quite basic design with sensors and antenna that will additionally help with communication around the Moon. Right now it is performing a mid-course correction to get to proper inclination after arriving to the Moon. Finally, it enters a slightly elliptical 1000 by 200 km orbit and it is ready to start its task of surveying the Moon. Sometime later, we are ready to send the outpost to its destination. Payload weight is about 22 tons. So I needed to use a Naga rocket with new Hydrolux upper stage powered by J2 engine. This stage will be responsible for TLI burn and most of the deceleration upon arrival. This is one of the first uses of Hydrolux in my career. As for now, I was focusing more on stage combustion engines, but using high energy propellant was quite useful for heavy payloads beyond LEO. J2 has ignited without any problems, and the outpost is on its way. I have plotted the correction to get to proper landing spot and performed it by using RSS. Surface was getting closer, so I decided to fire up the J2 once again, only to learn that it's not really designed to reignite after so long in space. I've quickly detached the transfer stage and tried to perform landing with only the sky crane, but I didn't have neither Delta V nor TWR to save the habitat. Luckily, there was no one on board. 3.5 months later, new lunar outpost was ready. It was launching with the same rocket, but the upper stage was heavily redesigned. And by heavily redesigned, I mean I've just switched the J2 to LR87LH2 vacuum, which doesn't mind reigniting after a long time in space, and it performs even a bit better than the J2. Transfer burn went perfectly fine. As well as the braking burn. During the burn, I was making a small corrections to land on the edge of the crater. It seemed to be the most attractive place for sighting. Empty stage was separated and the sky crane began the final approach. And we have a touchdown. But the sights are a bit underwhelming from that spot, and I still had some fuel left, so I've decided to move a bit towards the edge of the crater. The view was a bit better here, so the sky crane's engines were lit up and it flew away. After extending solar panels, I've realized they produce less energy than planned. It should still be enough, but to be on the safe side, I've decided to send a small supply mission to get additional panels to the outpost, and the crew will be able to attach them for extra electricity. Payload for this mission was much smaller, so Mage Rocket was enough for this task. But it also got a new Hydrox upper stage, but this one was powered by twin RL-10. This maiden flight went fine, and 4 days later supplies were approaching the moon. And again, transfer stage was also responsible for braking, and then the probe was detached. And I've realized I've put the wrong fuel mix to the core and the RSS were not working. Still, I've decided to try to land without full control. Lit the engines a bit too late, so the landing wasn't that smooth, and one of the solar panels got destroyed. I've decided that it is good enough, so it was time to send a crew. They will launch on Naga Heavy Rocket in Luna Direct configuration. It is a trusted design with many successful lunar missions, despite its tragic beginnings. Orbit has been reached according to the plan, and the translunar burn was also nominal. Solar panels were deployed and the capsule was on its way to the moon. After reaching lunar SOI, I've performed a correction maneuver to reach landing site. Getting closer to the surface, engine has lit up again, and I was adding some corrections to fine-tune the approach. I've overshot just a bit, but the final stage had enough fuel to compensate for it, and to land really close to the habitat. Now, on the surface, the plan was that the engineer, Günther Weber, would take all the equipment from the half-crushed probe and would bring it to the lunar outpost. Unfortunately, I've realized the equipment was too big to pick it up, and carrying it step by step would take ages. So I've decided to head back to the outpost and to wait for the lunar rover that was around to arrive to the site and use it as a truck to transport all the stuff. Originally, the rover was used to go around the surface during some of the earlier landings, but it could also be really handy for the base construction tasks. First plan was to place both solar panels on the truss on top of the habitat, but since only one has survived, I've just slapped it on the roof. Finally, astronauts could perform science with lots of electricity for their disposal. But eventually, all good stuff ends. And after a month stay on the surface, both Günther and Monika left the outpost to launch back home. Return trip was uneventful, and both of the crew members have safely made the touchdown and were brought back to KSC to prepare them for future missions. That would be all for today. Thank you everyone for watching, please press like and subscribe if you enjoyed it, and see you again in my next video.